The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... Marshall. Despite her modern tourist hotels, her up-to-date army, and her sophisticated position among world powers, Egypt remains an ancient land wrapped in mystery. The visitor today still thinks of Egypt in terms of the dynasties of the pharaohs. That is the lure of a people who believe so thoroughly in immortality that all of life was geared to enjoying what was to come. Egypt, the land of the living dead.
So scary, Hank.
The first total eclipse I've ever seen.
After that stark, blinding sunlight, it's unbelievable that we're sitting here in total darkness.
Once in a lifetime. It doesn't happen to many people. We're lucky.
I wonder.
Mystery drama, A Handful of Dust, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Ian Martin and stars Paul Hecht and Terry Keane. I'll be back shortly with Act One. The skyline of the Nile is dominated on either side by the outline of the pyramids, the Sphinx, the great valleys of the kings and queens, the fabulous remains of the great temples, Karnak, Luxor, Esna, Abu Simbel. The names are a roll of muffled drums that celebrate the belief of a people that the true life was after death, that the body could be preserved for all eternity, that, like the god Osiris, man too could rise from the grave, or woman.
On you, Ankhotep, who thought to deny me the glory of the afterlife, my undying curse. And from my living tomb, threefold be the curse on the woman Neshtari, who stole you from me. Cheated of her death, down through the ages, I will wait for my revenge on her daughter. Till the end of time.
Did I get your name right, Miss Kamen?
It's Kamen. C-A-M-M-O-N.
Oh, I'm sorry. I had it K-A-M-E-N. I'm sorry about that. What shall I call you?
You could try Nesh.
Is that your first name?
You better believe it.
What is it? Finnish?
No, just a nickname. My name's Vanessa, but the family shortened it to Nesh. I kind of got stuck with it.
Okay, Nesh.
What's your name?
Just plain Hank.
Hank what?
Theodore.
Dr. Conrad? Theodore's son?
Yeah, I guess I'll have to plead guilty on that.
Not so plain Hank after all. So your mother's that smashing-looking Egyptian princess, Marcia?
No, not a princess, and not my mother. She's my father's second wife.
I thought you looked a little young.
For my father?
No, for you. I mean to be your mother. You know what I meant. Never mind, I'm still impressed.
By Marcia?
How can anyone that young and lovely-looking be an archaeologist?
Well, you seem to have the bug. You're not bad-looking.
Oh, I'm just a little volunteer digger. That's another thing I'm impressed by. How come you were sent to pick up a nobody like me?
Oh, I just happened to be in Cairo. Dad asked me to pick up a whole bunch of you. I didn't know the rest would get bumped.
Oh, the group will be here on the next plane. They couldn't get out of Kennedy. Or the others, I mean. I was just lucky. Are we going straight to the dig?
Well, we were supposed to, but I guess now I'd better tread water till the rest of your contingent wafts in. I guess I'd better find you a place for the night. You have your money?
Are you kidding? I'm on a shoestring.
Well, there's Dad's apartment in Keys, but I'd be bunking in there, too.
Well, maybe I could find a youth hostel.
Yeah, it'd be easier if you were with me. Once I pick up the rest of the group, we've got to load up this old Land Rover and make tracks. It's a good 300 miles to the dig site.
You've got a roommate. But it's only fair to tell you, I'm a karate black belt.
Okay.
Listen, while we're waiting for the rest of the gang, you've got to take me sightseeing.
Listen, let me check that out with Dan. Huh? If he okays my hanging around for the others, you have a guide.
Conrad, that you?
Oh, yes, Marcia.
Where have you been?
There was a call for me in the radio phone. Hank from Cairo.
Oh, anything wrong?
No, not really. The volunteer diggers got split up. Some of them won't arrive till tomorrow. He wanted to know if he should wait for them.
What did you tell him?
Why not? No sense wasting the gas and the time and an extra trip.
It's a waste of time to bring them here at all.
Now, don't let's start that again, Marcia.
I have to, Conrad, for your sake.
For my sake?
Darling, it's your health I'm thinking about. You're overdoing. You haven't got the strength to waste on a hopeless cause like this.
I wish you didn't feel called on to keep bringing up the difference in our ages.
You know that's not what I mean.
Well, I know only that I'm an old man with a young wife. And I'm afraid no matter how I try to fight it, a guilty conscience.
Conrad, darling, I thought we had all that out before we got married. You are all the man I ever want. Or need.
Then don't try to undermine me.
I don't, sweetheart. Never. Except for that one thing.
What?
Your heart.
Oh, for heaven's sake, am I never to be allowed to forget that silly little attack? Oh, let's stop all this, Marcia. I prefer not to discuss it.
Conrad, please. Let me have the courage to tell you what all your little yes men won't. For once, you've backed a loser. You're chasing an empty dream. You're not going to find Mercegret's tomb. It's an illusion.
That is one bet I'd like to take.
What makes you so sure? She's only a legend. Probably never existed.
No, I'm convinced she did, Marcia. And you won't change my mind. I'm totally sure that in this valley, we are sooner or later going to exhume the tomb of the legendary Mercegret.
Selim doesn't agree.
Oh, Selim's a bumbling bureaucrat.
Oh, that's not fair. He's very well thought of in the government. No matter how much equipment you bring in from America, it cannot dig through those sifting sands. You can never find the Mestaba of Mercegret or any other of the Egyptian royalty, even if their tombs existed.
I can try. I know that Mercegret does.
How?
I just know.
But what purpose would it serve if you found it? If the legend is believed that she was buried without a single artifact, entombed alive with none of her household possessions, her jewels, what is the point of searching for her?
I feel that until I have discovered the secret of this enigma, I cannot rest.
Enigma?
Marcia, what dreadful act could a Pharaoh's queen have committed that caused her to be buried alive? And against every belief of the Egyptians, stripped of everything, so that even in death she could find no place in the afterworld.
What do you expect to find?
I don't expect I know, somehow, that the secret's to be revealed to me. And I will never rest until it is.
Selim?
Yes, Marshal. Did you talk to him?
Of course.
Son?
He is determined to continue.
Come here. To the entrance of the tomb, out of the wind. Can't talk here without being overheard. That tomb must never be found again.
I know, but this has become an obsession.
He must be stopped.
How?
Certainly, so there could be no suspicion that it was anything but accident. You would best know how.
Why me?
You are his wife. He has a bad heart, does he not?
The doctors have warned him to be extremely careful.
If only Allah willed him another heart attack.
That could be arranged. An overdose of his medicine could easily kill him.
Then so be it.
Not so fast, my brother. Suppose there were an autopsy.
We can guard against that.
How?
Incapacitate him enough with the medicine so I can drag him to the catacombs. I will arrange his death there to look like an accident, trust me.
Very well. tonight.
No. His son might be back by then. This afternoon. Does he take his medicine after lunch?
Yes, but these things are better done after dark.
It will seem more logical and read by day. And besides, Allah favors us with dark by then. Pitch black. Don't you remember?
The eclipse. Then after lunch. Yes. Maybe the eclipse is a sign.
Done too much reading on the subject.
I haven't done all that much.
Okay, take the pyramids, for instance. I'm really a geologist, but I'm assisting my father, one of the world's foremost archaeologists. I should say Egyptologists. But do you think I could have told you who built the third pyramid?
Menkaure. He was the son of Chefren.
Good. Who was the son of Cheops, old Cheops' grandson. But who remembers his name outside of the guides? Except you.
I do sort of have total recall, but it's not there. I feel kind of steeped in Egyptian history. And it isn't that I've read very much. I don't know how to explain it.
Hey, you don't have to.
It's as if all this stuff, even though it's 3,000-4,000 years ago, it's just sitting under this hot, blazing sun about to hatch and come alive again. Don't you get kind of a buzz out of it?
Not usually, but with you around. Yeah, I gotta admit, today is kind of funny. Like, things were standing still for a moment, waiting for something to happen.
Yeah?
The shadows. Don't you see them?
Yeah, clouds across the sky or something.
Well, there aren't any clouds today. Of course, I've forgotten this. There's an eclipse.
Oh.
No, don't look at the sun. Here, take my glasses.
Ah, there is a shadow. A crescent bitten out of one side of it. Oh, here, your glasses so you can see.
No, it's okay. I've got another pair in the rover. Let's get back to it so we can watch the whole thing. I'm on my way. I'll be there as soon as I can.
It's something terrible. What is it, Hank?
It's my father. He's dead. He had a heart attack. I gotta get back there. I'll drop you off somewhere.
Couldn't I just go with you? I might be able to help somewhere.
Okay. If you want to, it's your vacation. You've got a right to do anything you want to do with it.
It isn't a right. It's what I have to do. I don't know why.
And the Prince of Darkness, Set, will draw his veil across the light of Amun-Ra. And I, Mesabreth, will rise again to live out my term. Again to wreak my curse upon the daughter of Neshtari, whoever she may be, to the last and final generation.
An eclipse of the sun, a curse not centuries old, but measured in 3 millennia. A fair beginning for a story as stunning and eye-blinding as the reflection of the blazing sun from the white sand. Osiris, the mighty and all-powerful sun god, is all-powerful, except in those moments when he is casting shadow. In an eclipse, one tragedy has already struck. But how often is the sun found in eclipse? I shall return shortly with Act Two. An eclipse of the sun is a transitory thing. Even when total, the longest lasts perhaps 8 minutes. But to anyone who has experienced it, it is a profound and shattering occurrence. It reaffirms the insignificance of man and the majesty of the universe. The most sophisticated of us is awed by it. How profound its effect must have been on ancient civilizations is easy to imagine. How profound it is to be on the characters in our story is yet to be revealed.
What happened, Marcia?
I don't know exactly, Hank.
But you were with him.
When he had the seizure?
The heart attack.
It didn't seem that serious at the time. Otherwise, I'd never have let him go down to the tomb.
What time was this?
It must have been around 4 o'clock, just shortly before the eclipse. I'd forgotten about it, and then when I remembered, I rushed out to try to stop him before it was too late, and...
Well, what do you mean, too late?
Oh, I don't know what I mean. I just had this mad idea. He shouldn't be in Teokan's tomb when the sun was blotted out.
But there are lights inside the excavation. Why would the eclipse bother him?
You know the legend as well as I do. Teokan should be left in peace. And no one should even search for Mercegret's tomb. And no one must. Isn't what happened proof enough?
Are you trying to say that the statue that fell on my father and killed him was anything but just a terrible accident?
Of course not. Except...
Except what?
Osiris, the sun god, was blinded. Forces of evil ruled the world those few brief moments. And perhaps history repeated itself. You find that ridiculous to believe. Well, you are not born an Egyptian like me.
You believe that sort of nonsense?
I didn't say I did, but too many others may. And when a belief becomes pervasive enough, it can become a terrifying reality. Hank, we've got to face something.
What?
Your father, you, even myself, and Salem are interlopers. We are disturbing the dead. It's time we left them alone.
And abandoned my father's life work?
There are forces here beyond our comprehension. Dark, menacing threats that swirl up from beyond these ancient graves.
Are you trying to suggest that my father's death was anything but just sheer accident?
Hank, I only know I'm afraid. And that I was against this dig from the first. I begged Conrad not to start it, but it should be ended. Mercegret should be left in the tomb. If she is ever released, she could destroy all of us.
A woman dead for 3,000 years.
She was buried alive.
And so by now she should be deader than anyone in the Egyptian necrology. A mummy could still be preserved, but Mercegret must long ago have crumbled to dust. Ugh. I'd like to complete the job for him.
Hank, I beg you with all my heart, don't try. Let the dead past bury its dead.
It's too soon to make decisions. Just give me time to think.
Hank.
What is it? What is it, Marcia?
I'm so terribly alone. It's only you now. Hold me.
Don't, Marcia. You're too strong for that, and I'm having a hard time myself. We both loved him.
You'll have to speak for yourself, Hank. You know who I loved.
Don't drag that up again. Look, that was puppy love. It never meant anything. And
I don't believe you.
In the name of heaven, Marcia, that's all forgotten and dead.
Your father is dead, Hank. We're the ones who are living now. Come in. Oh, it's you, Salem.
Who were you expecting?
I thought it was Hank.
Ah, your son.
He is not my son.
Forgive me, your husband's son. He has gone down to the diggings. Is he ready to call an end to this exploration?
It's too soon to tell. Why did he go to the diggings?
I don't know. Perhaps to see where the accident happened?
I don't think I understand your tone.
Was it an accident? I thought you had some medicine to stop his heart.
I gave it to him, but he insisted on going to the tomb. He must have had the heart attack there. I suppose your toppling the statue on him was a good idea. It washed out the chance of an autopsy having to be performed.
I had nothing to do with this statue falling.
What? Then who...
I had supposed that you had contrived it.
Me? I was here. I wasn't within a quarter of a mile of the tomb. It was pitch dark because of the eclipse. I couldn't have found my way. Why do you lie about it? We both wanted Conrad's death.
Yes, but I had no part in it. The eclipse plunged me in darkness, too.
Then how... Unless my husband stumbled into the statue somehow and dislodged it?
2.5 tons of solid rock, unlikely.
If it wasn't you or me or Conrad, who else could it have been? You mean that Mercer Gret rose from the grave?
Reincarnate. To live out the old curse. To relive the 3,000-year-old legend. Only this time, to bring it to the end she desired.
Hey.
Who's that?
Oh, it's me, Nash. What are you doing here?
Oh, Hank. Well, the tomb was open. Nobody around. I thought it was okay to come in.
Well, there's been nobody working here since my father's death.
Oh, I didn't mean to. I just...
Why did you come in here?
All my life, I've dreamed of really being in a mastaba, an Egyptian tomb. I just couldn't resist.
Yeah, this tomb of Teokhan's has just been re-excavated. That's what we've been working on.
But it was excavated before, a long time ago.
Yeah, that's right. By my father on an earlier expedition. That's when he found the pottery shards with the legend.
The legend?
Yeah, about Teokhan's wife, Mercegret.
Tell me about it.
I don't really think I'm in the mood for...
Tell me about it, Hank. I want to hear what you know.
Okay. I'm trying to clear my head anyway. Here, come on, let's go and sit on that slab over there. Somewhere around the year 780 B.C., in the 12th or 17th or whatever it was, dynasty, there was an Egyptian pharaoh named Teokhan. And he was very rich, and the way things were going, he was riding high. He combined the upper and lower kingdoms by his marriage to a princess from the other side, but she died. And in his later years, he married a young, ambitious fireball who had a strong desire for the pharaoh's son, Ankhotep. The son was only a couple of years younger than his father's new bride, and he liked her. Only he never would have done anything about it because of his father. But Mercegret's feelings were something else again. So she knocked off Daddy to get at the son. Only it backfired.
How?
Well, that's where we don't have the whole story. Apparently, the son didn't care for Mercegret all that much, or he'd gotten over the spell, so for whatever reason, he dumped her.
Mercegret?
Yeah.
How?
He dug another tomb, or mastaba, because she had killed his father. He had her buried there, alive.
And it's her tomb you're looking for?
My father was.
But you're not going to continue?
What's the point? She was buried in it with nothing but herself and the casket. Plain stone, unornamented. There's no reason to exhume her, really, except to clear up a 3,000-year-old mystery.
I don't agree.
What do you mean?
The story isn't finished. Not half finished, the way you tell it. Wasn't there a curse of some sort?
From Mercigraph?
Yes.
Well, that's not wholly substantiated. It's just inferred from the potsherds and some hints in the hieroglyphics here in Teocon's mastaba.
Isn't the curse written above her burial place?
Well, we don't know. We've never found it yet. Look, why are you so interested in all this, man?
Because I have to be. We have to be.
Look, I'm
going to tell you what happened 3,000 years ago, so that at last you will know the truth. And I beg you to help me to live instead of die.
Well, die? What are you talking about, Nish?
I'm marked for death. Only you can save me.
Look, I have enough trouble without any crazy notions from you, no matter what they are. Look, we better get out of here and return to plain life.
We can't, till a lot of things get settled. Oh, don't you see that, Hank?
Come on.
The cards are on the table. You have to know the whole story of the legend.
And you're the one who knows it?
I'd better. My life is on the line.
Well, what does that mean?
If you don't listen to me, I might be dead.
What are you trying to say?
I don't want to complete the curse.
What do you know about it?
Come back 3,000 years. I can tell you how it really was. And I hope to make you believe. So that at last, we can all have peace.
Who is this strange girl who came from America, driven by a secret and special dream? And what is her intimate knowledge of an Egyptian mystery buried over 3,000 years? Is she hinting that she, Hank, his father, and his stepmother are all creatures of reincarnation? I shall return shortly with Act 3. Psychosis. Now, there's a fascinating word. It describes the passing of a soul into the body of another. Transmigration, or more simply, reincarnation. And it was a doctrine subscribed to, a belief profound among the ancient Egyptians. Perhaps if you are suspending your disbelief in this tale, you could be convinced as strongly as our young American girl who is learning to accept her recall of the past and the history of forgotten kings and queens.
Come on, Nish. I don't know what's got you all shook up, but it's time we got out of here.
Not until I tell you the story.
What story?
The story of all of us that began 3,000 years ago.
Hey, I don't think there's enough oxygen in here. We'd better get out.
Not until I bring the past alive to show you that for all of us it is being repeated again. Your father, the Pharaoh. Your stepmother, his young wife. You, the Prince Ankhotep. And me, the condemned Neshtar. Listen as time unfolds. And remember how it was then.
No, Mercigret, no. I will not go to war with the Upper Kingdom.
But Teocon, Setset has advised you. They have full granaries to be ravished and stores of gold to be plundered.
I do not attack my brothers because they are more fortunate than I. We have enough to sustain us.
We have little gold and precious stones to line our tombs to carry to the afterworld.
So be it. The gods will welcome us for ourselves and not the riches we come bearing.
Very kind and gentle, this Pharaoh Teocon. But his young bride was ambitious and grasping. She was not only anxious for power and plunder, but for something even more lustful to satisfy her passion. Oh, isn't it glorious?
What, Queen Mother?
The rain, Ankhotep. I welcome it here in our dry country. Doesn't it excite you?
I welcome it, yes. The earth needs it.
That's all. It doesn't stimulate you, thrill you with a promise of fulfillment.
I don't know. Should it?
Does anything thrill you with a promise of fulfillment anymore?
I don't know what you mean.
You know very well what I mean. I used to when I first came to this court.
That was before you were married to my father.
And now am I so far beyond your reach?
You are my father's wife. My mother.
The first is true, not the second.
We're almost the same age.
What are you suggesting?
I was given in marriage to your father. I would have preferred you.
You must be mad, Mercer Gray. Even the thought you are expressing could lead to death.
Not so long as they remain a secret shared between us, Anchorton.
A secret I cannot share. You are my father's wife. There can be nothing between us but my respect for you as the Queen Mother.
I hope you're very sure of that.
I am. I respect and revere my father. He is the living symbol of Egypt.
But if he should die?
The Pharaoh Teokon is in the prime of life. He has many years ahead to spread his glory and his fame.
If Teokon has been allowed to live out his allotted span. But Mercer Gret had other ideas, as did her evil brother, Setsut.
You sent for me, Majesty.
We are alone. No need to stand on ceremony. Setsut, he must go.
The Pharaoh?
Who else?
Because you cannot have the son without him gone.
That is my affair. There's more. Far more at stake than that. You wish to have the magic word to unleash our armies against the other kingdom.
Yes.
If I were seated in the throne of power, you could have it.
There is a son to succeed him.
Let me take care of the son after I have taken care of the father.
In the prime of his life, the Pharaoh, Teokan, fell sick of a lingering fever that none of the palace healers could identify. It was at that same time that the prince, Ankhotep, succumbed to a malady just as fatal. In a last diplomatic effort to forge better relations between the upper and lower kingdoms, the Princess Nishtari was sent as a delegate to the throne of Teokan. Her mission was more successful than could ever have been dreamed, because...
Nishtari.
Yes, Ankhotep?
I love you.
I love you, too.
If we were to marry, our kingdoms would be united.
Next to having you as my husband, that would be my dearest wish.
I wish it could be so.
Are you afraid your father would object?
No. Not my father.
You mean that woman he married, Mercy Good?
Yes.
She is evil. She hates my country. She will bring war and disaster on all of us until she is stopped. What's that?
The bell for the dead. My father. My father.
The Pharaoh was dead. Struck down by some mysterious disease. Ankhotep was the new Pharaoh, sharing the throne with the Queen Mother.
But it is ridiculous for me to reign as the Queen Mother, Ankhotep. I am less than 5 years your senior.
You were my father's wife.
You must forget that. Your father is dead. For the sake of the country, we should become man and wife.
For the sake of Mercegret, you mean?
Don't you find me attractive as you once did?
I don't know how I ever did. Now that I know what real love is.
You mean that foreign child, Nishtari? I should have poisoned her the first day she entered this house.
As you did my father?
I had nothing to do with your father's death. I only pray to the gods he was still alive.
Good. You can pray for him and yourself as you join him in the shadow of the tomb. But he will be denied the right to share his great journey to the other side. You will be buried alive.
To the tomb, and these were her last words before they sealed it.
On you, Amputet, my undying curse, and from my living tomb, threefold be the curse on the woman Nishtari, who stole you from me. Cheated of her death, down through the ages, I will wait for my revenge on her daughter, or the daughter of her daughters. down till the end of time.
Where did you read all this, Nash?
I didn't.
And how do you know it?
I can't explain that. Except one way.
Yeah? How?
My nickname, Nash. Close to Neshtari. Your name, Hank, almost like Ankhotep. Your family name, Theodore. And the pharaoh, Menteo Khan. And your stepmother, Marcia. Is that so far from Mercigret? Can't you see it's happening all over again? That all of us are the reincarnation of the original.
Do you know what you're saying?
Yes.
That my stepmother killed my father?
I think she did. And that Selim, whoever he is, helped to make an accident to cover it up.
How could you know that?
Because I am who I am.
You think you're a reincarnation of a girl who lived 3,000 years ago?
I'm sure of it. And I think, like her, I'm marked for death.
Look, unless... this is crazy. I haven't got the power to... The whole thing doesn't make sense.
Maybe it would be all right if we didn't open up her tomb.
Mercigret, we don't have any idea where it is.
That's simple enough. It's right under Teokan's sarcophagus. All you have to do is step on this stone here.
Maybe you are reincarnated after all.
No. I was poking about here in the tomb yesterday when your father came in. He didn't look well. I knew I was trespassing. So I hid. I saw him discover the way to open up the tomb under the sarcophagus. Then I heard someone else coming. I heard him say...
Who's that? Salem?
Yes, Professor Theodore.
Look what I found. Mercigret's tomb.
I see.
I'm not feeling too well. There's a shocking surprise for all of us here.
What is that?
As far as I can see, it's one huge arms cache. The terrorists must have discovered it before. I don't know what it is. I'm sick. Salem.
Yes, Professor.
I'm suddenly realizing how naive I've been. Your constant fight against this, Dick. All your resistance against its success. You were wrong, didn't you? You were trying to hide these weapons of destruction.
Since you are dying, I will admit it.
And my wife was in this with you.
We both believe the same cause.
You poisoned me. Somehow.
Why not? You come here to our world, remembering its ancient glory. We know that glory, too, and we feel it must rise again.
But... not on terms of terrorists. We're not alone.
Too late.
At least my death
will look like nothing more than a sad accident. I promise you I can arrange that before the tomb is closed.
I don't know what to say, Nash.
Neither do I.
I mean, how can I prove any of this? How much did you really see?
Enough to call Salem a murderer and your stepmother an accomplice.
Now, did you see Salem topple the statue?
No, not actually. I was hiding.
Now, how could we prove my stepmother poisoned him?
An autopsy.
No, it's too late. My father was cremated by his own request.
Look down in Mercigret's tomb. That arsenal of weapons in a tomb that was supposed to be empty. And those weapons aren't 3,000 years old.
That is quite correct, Miss. They are modern weapons, and we have a use for them.
We?
Your father's wife and myself.
Marcia.
I'd hoped it wouldn't come to this, Hank. If you hadn't rejected me, it might all have been handled so simply.
You're in with this terrorist?
I was born in this part of the world. My roots are here.
They go back a long way. 3,000 years.
Salem, how are we going to dispose of them?
Get them out of here first. I have men who will lose them in the desert and protect our secret.
First catch you here, then cook it.
No, Hank, don't!
Gotta take
no.
a chance!
No! Hank! Hank, here with me!
looks like a cave. It...
What caused it?
A pistol shot. Any loud noise in a cave or a catacomb can precipitate an avalanche. Gosh, we're just lucky that the rock over our heads held.
What happened to Salem and Marcia?
They fell into the tomb and it collapsed.
The scratched tomb?
Yep.
We've got to get them out of there.
No chance. They're buried. And their war weapons with them.
We could have been buried there. And the weapons to make war might have been free.
Sheer luck. Or maybe the gods had something to do with it?
I think they had. Somebody prompted me to be... What would you call it? Clairvoyant?
Whatever they did, I'll settle for it. Also that the past is dead. Well, let's take a good, long, happy look at where we go from here, Miss Tarly.
I don't want to hear any of those old names again.
Okay, I'm with you. From now on, you're Vanessa, also known as, I hope, Mrs. Hank Theodore. As soon as it possibly can be arranged...
Can it be true that all of us, somehow, are incarnations restored from a past life? Many people believe profoundly in this. A large body of scientific research can implement the belief. And some of the world's most widespread religions subscribe to this faith. I can't give you any answers. I never try to. I bring you the stories as I find them. You decide what they mean. Work was begun again on Mercegret's tomb, and it became an international story that hidden in it were enough weapons to have catapulted the Middle East into a catastrophic war. Lost in the headlines, and even in the small print, was the fact that in the small sarcophagus buried there, whoever had occupied it was a handful of dust. Our cast included Paul Hecht, Terry Keane, Jada Rowland, and Ian Martin. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown.
Radio Mystery Theater was sponsored in part by Ravenhouse Paperback Mysteries.
This is E.G. Marshall, inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.